And this right here, what does it look like for you? It's a hearing aid. It's not just a hearing aid.
It is.
It isn't. And in the next 10 minutes, you're going to realize that this is way more than just a hearing aid. Okay, so back in October 2023, we saw Starkey's most comprehensive release of hearing aid technology to date, with their Genesis AI family of hearing aids. And I have to tell you that the PR team working at Starkey at that moment in time must have been working on overdrive, as you couldn't look anywhere online without the Starkey team raving about how incredible this hearing aid technology was. Now, fast forward, however, to 2024, and I'll be honest now, I had no idea that Starkey's new tech was even coming. And I'd like to think that I've got my finger on the pulse when it comes to the release of any new hearing aid technology. So the big question is, why so quiet, Starkey? But panic not, my faithful YouTube community. I have looked under every rock and knocked on every door in the hearing technology world to bring to you as much information as possible on Starkey's new hearing aids. So introducing their Edge AI family of hearing tech. At the time of making this video, there are 7 new models available, from the completely in canal model, their in the canal or half shell rechargeable model, their in the ear rechargeable model, the receiver in canal disposable battery model, their micro receiver in canal disposable battery model, their receiver in canal rechargeable telecoil model, and then finally their cross system. Now, you'll notice that on the surface, this family of hearing aids look identical to their previous family of Genesis AIs. But Starkey are boasting that they've made some serious developments with what's going on inside. At the heart of this new technology is Starkey's new G2 neuroprocessor, which apparently leverages the power of artificial intelligence to enhance the user's listening experience in ways never seen before. However, don't take my word for it. Sherry L., property manager, and it's important that we know these people's job titles, by the way, says that her hearing loss isn't severe, but in her stage in life, she wants to be proactive. Good for you, Sherry. And Renee H., aerospace engineer, says that this tech is leaps and bounds ahead of where it was 2 years ago. And then finally, we cannot forget Brian L., music venue owner, who says that there are settings where he would never would have been able to hear people that he can now. So what exactly are these guys so pleased about? Let's look at some of these details. Now, believe it or not, the G2 neuroprocessor is Starkey's 7th generation of AI technology. And unlike conventional processors, the G2 incorporates a fully integrated neural processing unit, or NPU, with Starkey boasting that this enables the hearing aid to process sound in a way that is unrivaled by nothing other than the speed and the efficiency of the human brain. With this single chip design making it faster than competing products, significantly improving real-time processing. This G2 processor allows for Starkey's AI deep neural network to provide 100 times more processing than their Genesis AI hearing aids, and has been trained using millions of different sound environments. In turn, the Edge AIs will monitor your environment 60 times a second, gaining additional information from their built-in motion sensors, and can more accurately than ever recognize your listening situation, such as if you're in quiet, noise, or a group conversation. And then they'll detect the speech 30% more accurately than their previous Genesis AI family of hearing aids. On top of that, Starkey are boasting that it will give a mammoth, and this is huge, 13 decibel signal to noise ratio improvement. Now, whilst 13 decibels doesn't sound like a big number, I gotta tell you now, it is massive. And as far as I'm aware, it's the biggest claim we've heard from any hearing aid manufacturer to date. Now, of course, I always take what each manufacturer say about their own technology lightly, because no matter whether it's Starkey, Phonak, Widex, Resound, Oticon, or Signia, they all managed to report that their tech is 1 billion times better in noise and 400 quadrillion times clearer than the next guys. So those of you that tune into this channel regularly will know that I always wait a few months before I will give you a full review on any new hearing aid technology so that I can report back on not only what I find in clinic, but also what my team of 18 audiologists are finding along with all of our patients' feedback, rather than just reporting to you the inflated numbers that we get from each hearing aid manufacturer. So make sure that you subscribe to be notified as soon as I release my full review. So aside from maintaining speech understanding in noise, Starkey's focus is also to ensure daily listening comfort. And they have three features built in that are constantly running in the background in order to help you out with that. Firstly, they have their transient noise reduction feature, which is designed to reduce those sudden sharp sounds such as a door slamming or a dishwasher being emptied, for example. And this works by quickly compressing those sudden sounds. Now, quite cleverly, it attenuates the transients differently depending on your surroundings, with more reduction applied in quieter environments and less in those louder situations, which is exactly what you as a hearing aid user would want, as transient noises tend to be more overwhelming in a comparatively quiet situation. Secondly, they have their binaural wind feature, which until you've worn hearing aids without wind reduction features, you don't realize how important it is. Starkey's binaural wind noise management system quickly identifies and tackles continuous wind noise, reducing it by up to 35 decibels. Very simply, making being outside a lot more comfortable when you're wearing these receiver and canal hearing aids. My question to you, Starkey, is can you do this and maintain speech understanding at the same time? Answers on a postcard. And then Starkey's third feature for improving situational sound management is their binaural machine feature, which helps your hearing aid to identify sounds such as road noise, vacuum cleaners, or hairdryers, and reduce them to a comfortable level by as much as 22 decibels. Again, these are big numbers that Starkey are showing off with right now. Now, Starkey are promising all of this with a record-breaking 51 hours of battery life from a single charge. And they state that this is the case even if you spend significant amounts of time streaming. Now, I'm pretty sure that this is an industry record, which is a 20% increase over the industry standard. And this all sounds great, but to be honest, I don't really know why people do it. Why are the manufacturers doing this? A few manufacturers are following suit with this huge battery life. And in reality, all of my patients want to know is, will it last for a full day? If the answer is yes, then that's all they care about. Prove me wrong. Now, I've got to admit that I was getting kind of worried about Starkey being left behind in the connectivity space, as until this announcement today for this new technology, along with Widex, they have been left behind when it comes to LE audio and being Auracast ready, which will be a game changer in the headphone slash hearing aid space. Now, for those of you watching unfamiliar with this new technology that all hearing aid manufacturers have contributed towards, you'll benefit from having it in your hearing aids for two massively significant reasons. So the two that I can think of are, firstly, you'll see a significant improvement in the Bluetooth capabilities with your phone when it comes to sound quality and battery consumption. And that's whether you're listening to phone calls, music, and the radio or podcasts, all whilst keeping your phone in your pocket, giving you a truly hands-free experience. But that's not all. The second and the main benefit, in my opinion, is in a public venue with a built-in Auracast transmitter. Now, this new form of transmitter is specifically designed to work with newer LE audio technology and will send any signal directly to both of your hearing aids, such as if you head to a basketball game and want to hear the commentator, or when you walk into an airport and want to hear the announcements, or even if you head to a place of worship and you want to hear the sermon. Over the next few years, it's likely that we'll be seeing public venues installing these Auracast transmitters, and Auracast broadcasted audio will replace the century-old loop systems built into public venues that we have now. This will allow for multiple hearing aid users to simultaneously connect to audio in these public spaces, all with that same improvement in sound quality and significantly lower battery consumption that I mentioned before. And trust me, like I say, this is going to be a game changer. And not just for those of you wearing hearing aids, but I predict that this will be built into regular headphones too. Now, something important to note is that whilst this is built into these new hearing aids, it has not yet been activated. This will all be done in the future with a simple and free firmware update. And does it matter that it's not yet activated? Well, no, not really. It's because this tech is so new. As far as I'm aware, there are 6 public venues that have the Auracast transmitters installed. And that's on the whole planet. But I do promise you that I will update you as soon as that technology is available. Again, another reason for you to subscribe. Now, until Auracast technology takes off, I am delighted to announce that Starkey have included one model with a Telecoil built in, which a few manufacturers, and this is why I mentioned it, a few manufacturers have recently left this feature out. Now, the Telecoil is essentially a 20th century version of LE audio, and it allows for the streaming of sound in a public venue directly to both of your hearing aids anywhere that you'll have seen this sign. And it can make a huge difference in the likes of the theatre or in church, etc., etc. So I'm pleased that Starkey understands the time that it will take for Auracast broadcasted audio to take off and have still provided you with access to the Telecoil in the interim. And this also tells me that they're not expecting Auracast to be taking off anytime in the near future. As far as robustness goes, I will always welcome developments in durability that minimize the number of hearing aid breakdowns that we see in clinic. And Starkey have joined Phonak with a far more stringent testing process for all of their hearing aids to ensure that they spend more time in your ears and less time in the workshop being repaired. Their unique Pro 8 HydraShield waterproofing involves a Kevlar reinforced receiver, which is the same technology that's used in the military to make bulletproof vests. They've redesigned the acoustic ports, they've added an internal microphone mesh barrier, they've added a silicon seal on the casing, and also specially coated all of the internal components too. So here's an area that I have to be honest, I genuinely do not see the point of in any hearing aids. And I may open myself up here to a barrage of criticism from hearing aid manufacturers and users alike. So I would actually really like to get some of your feedback from you guys watching this video today. Now, what I mean by that is in the last few generations of hearing aids from most manufacturers now, there are certain features focused on step counting, fall detection, promises of heart rate monitoring, and time spent socializing, etc., etc. And I get it, and you don't need to explain to me why these features are a great idea. But I literally have no patience, not one, that want to use any of them. In fact, when I run through these capabilities, my words are often met with a roll of eyes and people saying, great, thanks, but will this help me to hear better in noise? And the answer is no. So let me know in the comments. I would love to be proven wrong. Do you think that health features are important to be built into hearing aids? Yes or no? Or would the manufacturers be better to spend their time and energy developing other features instead? I personally do. Saying that, the reason that I am here is to tell you what this hearing aid technology can do. And similarly to Phonak, Oticon, and Signia, the Edge AIs are embedded with 3D sensors that track your physical activity, including step counting and movement patterns. Starkey, however, are the only hearing aid manufacturers with an integrated fall detection system which can notify any emergency contact within seconds of you having a fall. Now, for those of you out there using iOS iPhones, I am particularly happy to report that the My Starkey app is now also supported on the Apple Watch, so you can adjust your hearing aid volume and programs from your wrist without needing to reach for your phone. Now, as mentioned earlier, my full review on this technology won't be available for a while, as for those of you that regularly tune into this channel know that I prefer to share all of the juicy details after I've fitted these hearing aids to a few patients' ears. But in the meantime, I wouldn't recommend making any decisions on the best hearing aid for you until you've seen this video on Starkey's biggest competition, the Phonak Infinio Sphere hearing aids.